guys, welcome back to my channel. I love my new setup so much. Sorry, I'm just like getting giddy about it. I love the fact that I don't have any lighting set up right now. I'm just using natural light, good old-fashioned natural light, and there is actual sun today, so that's all good. Anyway, let's get into today's video. So today we are doing another full brand review. Today's full brand review is going to be all about Kat Von D. So I was excited to do this brand next because if you guys did not see it, I will link it above. I recently started this series of full brand reviews and I started with the brand Benefit. So Benefit, I don't have a lot of positives to say about it. Not that I had a lot of negatives either. I just think it's kind of a boring brand. If you missed that review, sorry. To spoil it, but I just feel like there's not a lot to offer over at Benefit. So I felt like overall the theme of that video was a little so I wanted to go to a brand that I really love. Now, I'm not saying I love everything about Kat Von D, and we are going to get into that in a second, but I think Kat Von D's brand is pretty good overall. So what I'm going to do the same format that I used in my Benefit full brand review. We're going to start with the products that I love. Then I'm going to talk about some products that I dislike, and I'm also going to kind of talk about a few things that fall right in the middle, things that I think are okay but not that great, and I don't necessarily hate them either, they're just okay, if I could talk. And then we're gonna get into my overall thoughts about the brand. So overall, what I think about the brand, my likes, my dislikes for Kat Von D's brand, and that's what we're talking about today. I hope you guys enjoy watching these videos. I am doing a full series. If you guys missed the first one, I'll just briefly explain why I wanted to start this series. So if you didn't know, I did used to work at Sephora recently, just a couple months ago now, left working at Sephora, and when I worked there, it was really fun for all of us employees to like chit chat in between clients and talk about brands and products and just kind of like pick each other's brains, because we were all huge makeup lovers there, and all of us were, I mean, every single one of them is just as much into makeup as I am, and most of you watching these videos are. So it was always a really fun time to kind of like talk and about, you know, what do you think about this brand and everything. And I wanted to share my thoughts with you guys because those were always my favorite conversations working there, so I thought you guys might enjoy hearing my thoughts on the different brands. And I'm just gonna be going through my old store, so we're gonna be going through brand by brand every brand that we carried at my particular Sephora. So I'm not gonna be going over like Laura Mercier and things like that, because those are brands that I don't feel as knowledgeable about because we didn't carry it at my store. But for these brands, because I worked at that Sephora for about 3 years, I had a lot of experience working with all of these products. So yeah, that's what we're talking about. Let's go ahead and jump in. I have some products set out in front of me here. So what I want to start with are some of my absolute favorite products from the brand. So the first thing that I want to mention are these here. These are the Metal Crush Single Shadows from Kat Von D. I own 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shades. I don't know how many shades are in the collection. Let me pull that up real quick. I don't feel like we carried all of them in my store, so I think there was more than what we had, but let me see here real fast. Okay, so it looks like there are a total of 10 shades in the collection. This one that I'm showing you is called Dose. This one is a really good orangey copper shade. My favorite shade is this one here, which is called Thunderstruck. The reason I love this one so much is you can use it on your eyes or face as a face highlighter as well, and it's a beautiful kind of a yellow tint to it. You know what it reminds me of a little bit is the NARS Albatross, if you've ever tried that one, but not as yellow. I feel like the NARS Albatross is really hard to wear unless you have a very warm undertone, but this one I feel like is that same kind of color, but it works on all different skin tones. So I love this so much. I use it on both my eyes and face all the time. I do also have this shade, which is called Thrasher, which is more of a greenish gold shade. I also have this one, which is called Synergy, and it's a chocolatey brown shade. And the last one that I own is Raw Power. I honestly would love to own every single one of these. This is like a cranberry shade. I would honestly like to own every single one of these shades. They are $21 a piece, though. That's the only reason I don't own all of them. But you get a ton of eyeshadow in here. The pans are really, really large on these. I feel like it's something that once you invest in these, you're going to have them in your collection forever. So I really do love those. Now, if you have the new Metal Matte Miniature Palette. You will have some of these shades already in that palette. And if you have the original Metal Matte Palette, a lot of these are dupes too. So I don't necessarily need all of the individual ones, but I really just love the formula so much. It's one of my favorite formulas for a very intense, foiled, very metallic kind of an eyeshadow. They go on amazing, and they blend nicely, and they last all day. So I think the formula on these is fantastic if you're looking for a really good single eyeshadow with a metallic finish. I highly recommend those. The next thing I wanted to mention that I love, which is actually a discontinued item, and I was really sad that she discontinued these. These are the Everlasting formula of blushes. After she discontinued this, she came out with those other, I think they were called the Shade and Light blushes, where it was like a split pan blush, and the formula on those was horrible. There just was no pigmentation to them whatsoever, and they would just like fade so fast, like they just didn't last on the cheeks. But the formula on these were really, really nice. I believe she discontinued them because she is converting her line to all vegan, so she's been constantly reformulating things. So I understand why she discontinued them, but I wish she could come up with a vegan formula that was similar to these, because I think they are so fantastic. I love the packaging. I think the packaging is really sleek, really nice. The formula was really good. I only have two shades of these. I think you can still sometimes find these at like, you know, TJ Maxx and stuff like that. I believe that's where I found both of these at, but I've had them for a while now. This shade is called Por Vida. And then I do also have this shade here, which is called Love Song. I love Love Song. That's so pretty. So I really do like the formula of these. And like I said, I hope she comes out with something similar again. But if you find these like on Glambot or something, I highly, highly recommend picking them up, because they are actually a very, very nice formula. Next, one of my absolute favorite products from her is definitely her Shade and Light Contour Palette. This palette has gotten a lot of love. I love this palette. I'm close to hitting pan on this guy here, but this is such a great contour palette. It actually was always my go-to when I worked at Sephora for recommendations if I had a client coming in wanting a contour palette, because I think that it is super easy to work with. I like the powder one. That's the one I own. I don't personally like using cream cheek products, whether it be contour or blush or highlight. I'm just not a big fan of it personally. I feel like it's too difficult to work with. So I always prefer the powder, especially for beginners. Whenever I had someone come into Sephora looking for their very first ever contour palette and they didn't really feel comfortable with contouring, I always pointed them in this direction because it blends so easily. It's so fantastically easy to work with. It's just one of those foolproof products that is going to look good and it's easy to use. So I always recommended this one, and I definitely love it. I have the older packaging where you can't replace the palette, the individual pans. The new ones don't come in the cardboard packaging. She has the new packaging and you can replace the pans, which I think is really great. And definitely once I hit pan on some of these, I probably would purchase the newer one so that I can just replace the pans when I run out, because I think it's a great product. The other like face product, this is kind of face and eyes, but I don't know. I'm going to include it in the face product category because it could go either way. This is the Alchemist palette. So this was one of the first palettes that I remember seeing on the market that had those shades in there that were really like duochromatic or holographic. When you first open this palette, it does look super boring. It's like they all look the same, but each one of these has a very unique and beautiful shift to it. I'm sure you guys have seen this so many times. I think it's a really good formula. The only downside I would say about this palette is I feel like the powders, I wish you had a little bit bigger pan size, since this can be used as a face palette as well. I would have liked to see the pan size be similar to like the Glow Kits from Anastasia, but the formula is fantastic. So I think it is a really beautiful product. I love the way that they shift. You can, like I said, you can wear it on your eyes or your cheeks or your lips. I mean, you can really use these powders anywhere on your face. And I just think they're really stunning, and it's a good formula. So I definitely really do enjoy this palette. Another palette that I really love is my Shade and Light Eye Palette. This is the original one, the All Matte Palette. And again, she has redone the packaging on this. I have one of the original ones with the old cardboard packaging, but the new one looks like the new Shade and Light face palette. So I think that the formula on these are fantastic. They're really easy to blend. They're really easy to work with. I love the color combination. You get a really good assortment of neutrals, cool tones, and warm tones all in one palette, and it's all matte. So it's gonna give you so much versatility. Whenever I have like an all shimmer palette that I'm working with and I need some mattes, this is a great option to pull in as like a supplementary palette. Or you can just do an all matte look with this. And I feel like every time I use this, it looks stunning. It's super easy to blend, and everything looks really nice and polished whenever I use this. So I think this is a really, really good palette. I really recommend it. Are these here? These are the lip liners from Kat Von D. I think these are a fantastic formula. They are very comfortable. They're not overly drying, and they're extremely long wearing. So if you want to have like a similar look to a liquid lipstick without the overly drying feeling, I would recommend trying these, because you will get a super long wear time without that really crusty dry feeling that you can get from a liquid lipstick. And then I did have a couple of favorites that I wanted to mention that I don't personally own, but I have used on clients and I think they're fantastic products. They're things that I would like to have in my collection, but I don't currently. Actually, the first one is the Tattoo Liner. I'm gonna insert pictures. This one I actually have owned before. I just don't currently have it in my collection. It is $20. I think it is a great liner, but I have found some drugstore dupes that I think are so similar that I don't necessarily like purchasing this one, if that makes sense. I'd rather save some money, but I think it is a really good liner if you've never tried it. And then I do actually really like her collection of brushes, both her face brushes and eye brushes. They are very, very good quality. They're actually fairly affordable for what you are getting. I think they're right in line with the price of the Sephora collection ones and the like MAC brushes. So I think that they are really, really nice brushes. I was really glad to see that she moved away from the dual-ended brushes, because all of her brushes when she first came out with brushes were the double-ended brushes, which are a pain for storage if you have a storage like I do where they're all in like jars or something like this. You can't really store a dual-ended brush in that kind of a system. So I was really happy to see that she came out with these brushes, and it's something I would eventually like to purchase, but like I've said, I just haven't gotten around to purchasing any of them yet. All right, and then I wanted to mention her limited edition palettes. So I want to get more into these near the end of the video when I talk about what I like and dislike about the brand altogether, but I will say I do have a lot of her limited edition palettes. These three here, this is actually just a discontinued palette, but this is the Chrysalis. I guess I always say that wrong and I get a comment every time. This is the Chrysalis eyeshadow palette. It's got like those purples and blues. It's actually a really stunning palette. She did discontinue this and the Monarch palette, but these three are all holiday palettes. So I do have the Mi Vida Loca, I have the Metal Matte, and then I have this year's Saint and Sinner. Now, the Mi Vida Loca, I love this palette so much. I love the artwork on it. I wish the packaging wasn't like the slide out, but I do really enjoy the artwork that's on here. And I love the shadows themselves. I think it's a beautiful, beautiful palette. The Metal Matte palette I think is fantastic. I love the formula of both the Metal Crush formula as well as the mattes that are in here. And I love the assortment of colors. I think this is also a fantastic palette. And then the Saint and Sinner palette I think is okay. I found that she definitely had changed her formula up with this palette, and I don't feel like it lasts on my eyes as well as her other eyeshadow formulas, so I'm not sure what happened with this one. And I'm not saying all the shades in here are that way, but a lot of the shades I found would fade on my eye very quickly. And then I also was very thrown off by the layout of the eyeshadow colors that are in here. I think there's some fun, beautiful colors that I'm definitely drawn to. I just wish it was organized a little differently. And I have seen a lot of people on Instagram like reorganizing this, depotting it, and like gluing them in the way they want it to. I personally am not good at depotting, and I know I would break a lot of powders if I did that, so I'm not gonna try it, but I just wish it was assorted a little bit differently. But it's still a very beautiful palette and I still do use it. And I am gonna get back to the limited edition thing in a minute, but I wanted to go through next some of the least favorite products from the brand. Now, I don't have any of them with me here, but I do have a few things that I dislike from the brand, and I'm gonna talk about those real quick. I just have my app pulled up so I don't forget. So I might look down a little bit. The first one is the liquid lipsticks. Now, I have owned many of the liquid lipsticks, a lot of the colors. We got them in gratis a lot, and I purchased quite a few when I was hoping to like the formula. Every time I mention that I dislike the liquid lipsticks from Kat Von D, I get some pretty angry comments. Like, people are completely offended that I don't like them. So I do apologize if you like the Kat Von D liquid lipsticks. I know my opinion is not the popular opinion on this product, but that's the beautiful thing about this community, is we don't all have the same taste and we don't all like the same things. And this particular product did not work for my lips. I definitely have more dry lips, and I know that, so I have to be really cautious about what liquid lipsticks I wear, and this one is just way too drying for me. It really dries out my lips, so if you don't like a very drying formula, you probably would want to steer clear of these liquid lipsticks, but they are a lipstick that is going to stay on your lips all day, so definitely gives you the long wear time, but I found that they were just so uncomfortable and so drying to the point where they would crack and peel on the inside part of my lip that I couldn't get enough wear time out of it to make it worth it. So those are definitely one of my least favorite things from the brand. The next one is definitely personal preference. I do not like the Kat Von D Shade and Light Cream Contour Kit, but again, it's just, as I mentioned earlier, because of my preferences. I don't like using cream face products, and if you feel the same way, you'd probably just skip right over that product as well. For myself, it's not something I would ever see myself reaching for. Next up is actually her fragrance. So the Saint and Sinner fragrance, if you guys didn't see, she just re-released those this last year. And this again is just totally personal preference. We actually got the rollerball for both the Saint and Sinner in gratis, and I ended up gifting them because I just don't really like the scent. I love Nirvana Black and White, so I kind of thought it would be like a similar thing with the more musky and then a sweeter version that you can kind of wear separately or layer them, which is basically the same idea with Saint and Sinner, but I just didn't like the way they smelled. I didn't like Saint or Sinner on their own, and I didn't like them layered together either. So for me, I just didn't, there's something about it I just couldn't get on board with. All right, and then the last, like, really dislike for me from the brand would definitely be her Shade and Light Shimmer Palette. I've never personally owned it, but I have swatched it a lot in store and used it on clients, and I just felt like there was something really weird about the formula. Some of the powders were nice, but some of them just were like glitter that didn't stick, so you'd have to really, really put down a good tacky base, and I just feel like there are better formulas out there for a glitter or a shimmer eyeshadow that I didn't see the point of spending the money on this one, because I didn't think the formula was that great, and I did not find the formula to live up to her other eyeshadows. When I heard the Shade and Light Shimmer was coming out and that it was going to be basically like a sister palette to this one with the same colors all in like a shimmer or metallic finish, I was expecting the formula of these, like the Metal Crush, like a really saturated, beautiful, easy to work with kind of formula, and it just wasn't. It was really, like I said, difficult to work with. Never actually owned it or tried it on my eyes, but just swatching it alone and even swatching it over like the Too Faced glitter glue, the glitter would fall away and it just didn't stick well, and it wasn't pigmented, so personally that was a fail for me. Okay, and that is pretty much it for my dislikes. Like, there was not very much from this brand that I really disliked. All right, and now I do have a couple products sitting in front of me that I think are okay, and basically everything from the brand that I did not mention are those products that fall right in between for me that I think are okay, but not my favorite. For example, the foundation. I think this is an okay foundation, but I have other foundations that I think are better than this one, but this is a really good full coverage, bulletproof foundation that just stays on. Now, I do also have her Lock It Translucent Setting Powder. This is not my favorite either. I feel like there is some definite glitter in here. I definitely prefer my Laura Mercier powder or my Cover Effects powder to this one. I just don't find that this one lays as beautifully on the skin as those powders. I do also have this here, which is the Color Correcting Eyeshadow Primer Stick. I think this is nice. I definitely use it, and I haven't decluttered it because I do use it, just like the last couple products. It is basically like an eyeshadow stick, and you just apply it all over your lid, kind of rub it in, and then set it, and it works like a primer and also a color corrector in one. The only thing about it is it is a little bit sticky and thick. So you have to be really sparing with how you use it. And I prefer using it when I'm using like a glittery eyeshadow or shimmery eyeshadow and I want a tacky base. That's usually when I will use this, but you still have to kind of set it because it will move around on you. And then the last thing that kind of falls in the middle that I own is these lipsticks, the studded lipsticks. She has recently discontinued these. She's coming out with a new formula again, but I thought these were okay lipsticks. They weren't anything special, but she did have some good color selection, which I thought was nice. All right, so those are all of the individual products that I wanted to talk about. Now let's get into my overall thoughts about the brand. I want to start with the positives. So first of all, one of the things I love about Kat Von D is that she has a very clear idea of what she wants her brand to be. She's always stood behind being cruelty-free. She's never wavered with that. She's very adamant about keeping her brand cruelty-free, and now most recently she has transitioned into vegan as well. I believe her whole brand is vegan now. She was doing like a slow transition, but I believe it all is now. So that was something that was important to her as well, and I really admire that she has taken that stand and that she's been very vocal about it and that she's been very committed to doing that with all of her products. So that is something that I definitely admire. I also really appreciate that when she does limited edition, so like all of these palettes, when she does a limited edition palette, it is limited edition. So all of these were holiday palettes. As soon as the holiday season was over, she would put any of them on sale that are left, and then that was it. She would stop production. She doesn't bring it back later. I feel like all of us as consumers are really over the whole limited edition when we know it's really, when we know that it's really just coming back in a couple of months. So that's something I really appreciate about her and her brand. I feel like I trust her a little bit more because of that, if that makes sense. I feel like when she says she's doing something, she sticks to it. Like her cruelty-free, her vegan, and even down to, you know, limited edition. If she says it's limited edition, it really truly is, and I appreciate that about her brand, and it definitely makes me want to support her more. Like you have seen, I have all of her holiday palettes, and I don't typically run out and buy holiday palettes. I don't own any of the Too Faced holiday palettes. I don't own any of the Tarte holiday palettes. I buy the Kat Von D ones because I believe in her brand and I believe in her product, so that is why. I also think that she is very meticulous in her planning. If you guys follow her on Instagram, you would know this, but I definitely recommend following her if you don't already, if you like her products and her brand. She is very meticulous about her products. She will test them out herself. I think a lot of other companies have all these different people testing for them, but she tests every single product she creates, every single shade from the product line, over and over and over again until she feels confident with it before she ever releases it. So I feel like that's why she has so few misses in her collection, is because she is really doing her due diligence and making sure that she stands behind every single product before it hits the shelves. She also designs all of her packaging, and as you guys know, she is a tattoo artist, and she used to be on a show. I can't remember the name of the show, like a reality show. So all the artwork that is on her palettes was her artwork, and I think she's a very talented artist. She's talented with her makeup artistry as well, so she comes from a very artistic background, which I very much appreciate, and I think it is beautiful, and so for that reason, I do like supporting her as well. So those are my favorite parts about the brand. Now we're gonna get into some of my least favorite parts about the brand. Okay, so for least favorites, I definitely wish that she would come up with some new face products. So as I mentioned when I was talking about these blushes, she doesn't really have any blushes in her collection right now, nor does she have individual highlighters. She just has like basically the Alchemist palette, and she doesn't have any individual bronzers. She just has her Shade and Light palette and then like the refill pans individually. So I would love to see her come out with some more face products. I would love to see her come out with maybe another foundation, maybe a more lightweight foundation, and just kind of expanding her product line a little bit to you know, so that she had a product for every different category. I think that would be really fantastic, especially for employees. It was always one of those things, the brands that we had a full collection for, where if, let's say I was sitting someone down and doing a custom makeover, if I could grab a product from start to finish for a full face from one brand, that was really important as a makeup artist, that was really important. But also, if you're just a really big Kat Von D fan, we had clients that would come in and they would not use any other brand. They only used Kat Von D, mainly because of her morals, mainly because she believes so firmly in cruelty-free and vegan. We had a lot of clients wanting those products, and a lot of brands, it's hard to know whether they're cruelty-free, and definitely hard to see if their products are vegan, because they may have one or two products from their line, but definitely no other brand that I know of that is all vegan at Sephora, at least at the location where I was working. So we would have clients that came in and that was the only brand they'd want to buy from. And since Kat Von D didn't have, individual bronzers or blushes, then they would not be able to purchase those products. So I would definitely like to see her expand her line a little bit. I know she's constantly coming out with new products, so I don't think it'll be long before she brings something out to us. I'd also really love to see lip glosses. I know she has those glitter toppers, but I'd really love to see some like true lip glosses. I feel like that is a trend that we're moving back towards, is more glossy kind of finishes for the lips, and I'd love to see what Kat Von D comes up with in that category. And I would definitely like to see her come out with some other eyeliners and some mascaras. She did have a mascara for a while. I can't remember the name of it. Was it the Everlasting or something like that? I can't remember, but she doesn't have any mascaras in her line currently, so I'd love to see maybe a couple different mascaras from her. And then liners. She does have like a couple different liquid liners, but some just like pencil eyeliners would be fantastic as well. So I would really just like to see her brand expand. That is the main thing. I don't have a lot of negatives to say about Kat Von D's brand. Like I said, I feel like she's very well thought out. I really feel like she stands behind her morals, and I really appreciate that about her. So I think it is overall one of my favorite brands that we carried at my location. I do have a lot of her products, and I definitely plan to try more of them in the future. So I hope you guys enjoyed this total brand review for Kat Von D. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below and let me know what you guys would like to see next. I was thinking maybe either Urban Decay or Lancôme, but let me know your thoughts, and I will see you in my next video. Bye, guys.